It all started 10 years ago. Something has happened to our world. The predictions of scientists were coming true one by one. First, that beautiful blue sky rebelled. Then the air got polluted. And then our seas. Farming is about to end. The parks are empty. Happiness is lost on people's faces. The voices of children in the streets are missing. A second world? Could we have a second chance? Perhaps Mars.
After the space adventure that started at the Mars on Earth project Analog Mars Research Station, today I am a MoEP-in too. Join us and let's explore Mars together. If you are ready, let's go!
Capsule 22. This is a Starship Control Station. Connections unlocked. Get ready to dock on deck 923.
This is Capsule 22. We are in agreement. We received approach instructions. Robotic catch arms open. We stop the thrusters. Roger.
Commander of the BURAK-I spaceship. Do you copy? This is the International Mars Landing Base Flight Control Base. Your landing has been confirmed. We're sending the instructions to your flight computer. Welcome to your second home. Artificial Intelligence Operator Nerman is terminating communication.
Commander, crew carrier rover ready. Your arrival time at Alpha 1 station is 4 hours 12 minutes. Oxygen level nominal. Rover battery power 100%. Atmosphere UV level is low. There are 96% carbon dioxide, 1.9% argon, 1.9% nitrogen and free oxygen, carbon monoxide, water and methane. Atmospheric pressure 600 Pascal. The temperature is minus 53 degrees.
The first virtual Mars mission studies in Turkey are carried out by Mars on Earth project, MoEP. MoEP Virtual Mars mission is the first study using real satellite communication with the support of scientists and amateur radio operators under the control of mission moderators. The scenario and study area of each virtual task are different. Now let's introduce you to the first virtual mission. Year 2047. Dukan Crater, Mars. Mission codename, BURAK-I. A mission force of female biologists was sent to the Alpha-1 base for 7 sol with a crew carrier rover. Every sol represents accelerated 100 sol. Hence, the total mission period is accepted as 2 years. Mission Force Crew has been assigned to perform microorganisms and plant-based research on Mars soil and examine the effects of Mars gravity and surface radiation on living organisms from different aspects. Task instructions are sent to Virtual Mars Pigeon Orbital Satellite, VMPOS, which is 381 million kilometers away, via the Virtual Deep Space Network, VDSN, on Earth. The instructions received by the Mars Satellite Ground Control Station are transferred to the Alpha 1 station, 70 km away, via ground-to-ground radio frequency link. The Alpha 1 crew also delivers the task report to the Earth over the same network. So you can think of how this will take place in a virtual task. MoEP combines virtual and real-world technology to ensure these tasks are close to the reality. But how are we doing this? Let's continue and see where and how reality is combined with the virtual. As communication hardware at the virtual Alpha 1 station, we have Mars Emergency Data Network ground-to-ground RF link, which works in 2.4 and 5.8 GHz frequencies. VHF, UHF, dual-band radio, and dipole antenna, HF radio and dipole antenna, and rotor-controlled Yagi antenna equipment for scatter. The Virtual Mars Emergency Data Network RF link occasionally malfunctions due to the winds and Mars dust consisting of iron oxide, which sticks to the antennas. In this case, the Alpha 1 crew can communicate with Mars Phobos Mars, MPM, and Mars Deimos Mars MDM signal reflection via natural satellites Phobos, which is 9,000 km away, and Deimos, 23,000 km away. In case of failure of this system, some automatic terminal information messages published from the colony can be followed.
This is the Alpha Tango India Sierra 23719 Virtual Mars Mission Automated Message Station, Sol 7. The solar wind index is high. Remote stations are required to enter secure underground shelters.
Meteorological screening can be taken twice a day from meteorological satellites. In addition, files of the Alpha 1 station are archived on Mars Spatial Internet Network, MarsNet, servers. But the question is, how is the virtual Mars communication scenario simulated in real life? The MoEP-Virtual satellite communication station in Finland is the equivalent of the virtual deep space network on Earth. Virtual Mars Pigeon Orbital Satellite is equivalent to the Virtual amateur communication satellite in orbit 36,000 km geo. Virtual task instructions will be sent to the satellite by our operators here. German MoEP-Virtual satellite communication station is equivalent to the Mars satellite ground control station. Virtual task instructions will be taken from the satellite by our operator here. The same station will also forward the task reports of the virtual mission crew. 2.4 and 5.8 GHz Virtual Mars Emergency Data Network RF links represent ground-to-ground amateur radio emergency data network and will be used in this virtual mission. The amateur radio communication with Phobos and Deimos via MPM and MDM reflection communication represents the amateur radio communication with Moon, which is 384,000 km away from Earth via Earth-Moon-Earth, EME, also known as Moon Bounce. This system will be used in the virtual mission. The mission crew will use WebSDR system instead of VHF, UHF, HF communication. For Morse and automatic terminal information messages, the virtual task crew will also use WebSDR. The SSTV signal, which is encoded for the mission and sent to the crew, will be used for taking meteorological satellite map images and decoding. And the interplanetary file system structure will be used as MarsNet. We are proud and excited about the first virtual Mars mission of Turkey. If you get excited too, join us. Follow our social media platforms for recent news about the mission.